right, so Fred and Derek had to take off and take care of something, but luckily I have a friend here to bring me the scripts that I need to call these next highlights, and we're going out to Indiana. Thank you so much. It's very appreciated. We're going out to Indiana to check on Silver Creek. They are hosting Charlestown tonight, so we're going to go to the Silver Creek student section where they were definitely prepared for the water out there. They've got their swimmies, they've got their floaties. If this rain reached flood proportions, they were ready for it. So the Pirates got rolling early, deep in Silver Creek territory. Matt Myers takes the handoff, not going down anytime soon. He busts through some tackles and into the end zone. And Charlestown takes an 8-0 lead after a 2-point conversion. Next possession, it's 4th and goal from the 5, but the Silver Creek defense stands. Dragons take over on downs. Very next play, though, they get right back. Jake Harper, the linebacker, not going down. You're not stopping him. He takes it in. That makes it 14-0 Pirates, and that's the final score.
So let's check in on North Bullitt hosting Oldham County in the rain, of course. Third quarter, we go. Caleb Allen takes the carry, and he's going to bust one up the middle for the first down. They are moving the chains over there at Oldham County. Now, later in the drive, Allen finishes what he started, the short TD run, and that makes it curls up 14-0. So later in the quarter for the Eagles, how about Logan James? Check this out, the keeper. Going to go left coast to right coast. Watch him run. Picks up a big gain on the carry, but it's raining and the ball is wet. So coughs it up, and it is recovered by Jordan Vire. So Allen would get his number called once again, picks up another rushing TD. They go up 20-0. Oldham County, they go on to win this one big. 33-0 is the final.
Kentucky football at Iroquois. Kentucky's 2A is second ranked to sail, so to Shawnee wet. Taylor Boulevard was a very moist place this evening. First quarter, no scores. Shawnee quarterback Cody Harrell tried to get something going right away, but he was picked off. The Colts, Connor Shipley. Later, Shawnee got the ball back, and we got wetter and wetter. Golden Eagles tried to get something going again, but the wet conditions made it tough for Harrell to hang out of the ball. Fumble! Shawnee did recover that one. Still scoreless first quarter as it got wetter. DeSales turn. Quarterback Nathan Roush on the keeper, but he also fumbled. And the Golden Eagles defense recovered this time. Eventually, the Colts took over. DeSales won it 49-0 for a 5-0 record this season.
DeSales looking good early on this season. Central on the road taking on Western. First quarter we go. Western, well, they're going to turn the ball over. We saw a lot of that in the highlights because it's wet. Royshawn Beeson would recover for Central. Now, later in the quarter, James Simpson, new quarterback in for Central. It's not Tedford. He's back to pass, connects with Daquan Mobley in the end zone for the score, and Central is up 6-0. Now, after a Central safety, Western would come up with the fumble, and this time it's going to go 65 yards deep into Central territory. However, they could not convert and punch it into the end zone. Central, though, they would go on to win this one by the score of 20-14.
So wet, you could hear the rain. Still to come, highlights of 4 more games, like Dawson Butler High School. Playbook continues on WLKY.